the hand of the Lord was upon me. He brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord and set me in the middle of a valley. It was full of bones. He led me back and forth among them, and I saw a great many bones on the floor of the valley. He asked me, "Son of man, can these bones live?" I said, "O sovereign Lord, you alone know." Then he said to me, "Prophesy to these bones and say to them, 'Dry bones, hear the voice of the Lord. I will make breath into you and you will come to life.' Then you will know that I am the Lord." So I prophesied as I was commanded, and as I was prophesying, there was a noise, a rattling sound, and the bones came together, bone to bone. I looked, and tendons and flesh appeared on them, and skin covered them, but there was no breath in them. Then he said to me, "Prophesy to the breath and say to it, 'Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe into these slain that they may live.'" So I prophesied as he commanded me, and breath entered them. They came to life and stood up on their feet, a vast army.
The inspiration behind Come Alive was I had a friend back home who was raised in the church, and he, you know, kind of had this season away from the Lord. And it made me think about, you know, all the prodigal sons that had stepped away from God and had known his word, had known his calling, but just stepped away at some point in their lives.
I think we just wanted to step in to a moment to help maybe craft a song in a moment that put courage to believe,
yeah,
and courage to have faith back into those that are actively watching the prodigals around them and going, "Lord, bring them back."
I don't know if you remember this, but you said, "Let's write this song for that mom that's praying for her son."
It was very specific.
Yeah, you were like, that mom that's sitting there every night just weeping before the Lord saying, "God, take my son back into your arms. Let's write the song for that mom." And whenever we, you know, started singing, he started talking about dry bones, and it reminded me of the passage in Ezekiel 37 that talks about God leading Ezekiel down into the valley and saying, you know, "Call out to these bones and I'm going to resurrect them to life."
You hear the Lord say, "Son of man, can these bones live?" And Ezekiel responds, "O sovereign Lord, you alone know." And then the Lord says, "You prophesy to the dry bones and I will give them breath." Mm-hmm. But he invites us into, there's an action required that we get to join him. We have no power in ourselves, but we're walking alongside the one who has all the power.
And man, just when you sing it, it's like you can just feel the army like coming up.
Worship causes action.
Yeah.
But I'm telling you, it makes the enemy tremble when God's people stand together in his presence, say, "We will join you. We'll speak it and you make it happen."
Yeah.
It's just what he does.
Yeah.
He invites us into it. And I don't know that there's anything more powerful than us being able to stand in that place with those kind of authority words, those authority prayers. "You will come back home. You will follow the Lord." And the Lord moves into action with it. It's powerful.
Yours is the victory. We know there is there's more to come that we may not yet see. So with the faith you've given us, we'll step into the valley unafraid. Yeah. As we call out to dry bones, come alive, come alive. We call back the way.